Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making New Year's Eve Strawberry Colada Punch. Now last year I made a drink for you for New Year's Eve, and I'll just summarize it in case you would rather have that drink. It was made of pineapple sherbet along with fresh strawberries, and then champagne was poured over that. So that was a champagne drink, and if you want a champagne drink, that's really a pretty one and a good one. But I decided this year I didn't want to repeat myself by doing another champagne drink, so we're doing colada. And it's not pina colada, it's strawberry colada. So we're starting with strawberries. And I have a container of frozen strawberries here. This is a 15-ounce container, and it's still partially frozen. So you need to thaw it to some degree, but you want to leave ice crystals in it. And I've kind of gone through with a knife to separate this so it won't go out in one big chunk when I put it in the blender. But that's the first thing I have to do, is get my blender ready to go. Make sure this is locked in, and we'll put our 15 ounces of partially thawed strawberries in there. And those came sliced. I got some there on the edge. We'll take care of that in just a minute. Now going with that is coconut milk. And this happens to be a light variety. And we have 13.5 ounces. And all of that goes in. And I did pour it out here just so it would be quicker to get it into the blender, because my two openings at the top would probably slow me down a bit. Now we have these two major ingredients in, and we're going to stop and do a little blending. So let's put the lid on. And my plan is to pulse this a little bit and then blend it until it's smooth. And I do have a spatula here, so I can take the lid off occasionally, go down and scrape the sides. So I'll have to be away from you most of the time while I'm doing that. So here we go, I'm going to get started on this. Just turn it. So here we have this beautiful mixture of strawberries and coconut milk. What we're going to do is place it in a large container, and I happen to have a punch bowl, so I'm going to just pour that in. You can see how smooth it is. There will be little chunks of berry and maybe strawberry seeds, whatever, but it's nothing that you would pay any attention to, so I would say that is smooth. Now the next thing we're putting in is pineapple juice. So if you can get some pineapple juice, pure pineapple juice, you need to shake it right before you put it in, and it should be chilled so that it will not warm this up. So 3 cups, I placed it in here just for easy pouring. 3 cups will be going in here. That gives it a really good flavor, the pineapple along with the strawberry along with the coconut. And next comes club soda. So we're going to need 3 cups of chilled club soda. I have it measured out here, and I do this gently because it could bubble up some. Just pour 3 cups in there. This is very easy to do, and it's very impressive. And I'll be showing you the end product in a minute or two, but you can spruce it up quite a lot if you want to. See it bubble? That gives it kind of a carbonation that will make it a really zesty drink also. Now we come to the alcoholic part. You may make this alcoholic or not. That's up to you. If you choose to make it alcoholic, the best liquor to use is rum. A light rum. This is gold Puerto Rican rum. And I have measured out 1 cup. Actually, this recipe calls for 2 cups of rum. And I didn't even know if Rick wanted to put rum in this time, so what should we do? 2 cups of rum or no rum or what?
1 cup would make for a real happy medium.
Okay, I'll agree with that. I think 1 cup will be plenty for me, and I think it will give it just a little bit of nip that you might like on New Year's Eve. So I've measured out 1 cup. If you decide to leave out the rum, remember there were supposed to be 2 cups, then you would just put 2 more cups of your club soda. Since I only used 1 cup here, I did measure out ahead of time just in case this is the way it worked out. This is 1 additional cup of club soda just to keep it even with the liquid measurements. And that's all you put in it. So let me clean this up a little bit and make it look a little prettier, and then I'll serve it to you. I have put the final ingredients in and I've stirred this around. And I've got my little glasses. Actually, this is an antique punch bowl that I don't have the cups that came with it, but I had the little antique juice glasses and I thought that would work fine. And if I had more people, then I just have other glasses of different types that I would use. So it'd be nice if I had a really fancy ladle, but here I'm just using a utility type ladle and I'm coming over some crushed ice with it, and there we have our little drink, our strawberry colada punch. It would be really nice with a chunk of pineapple on the top, wedged on the top, or a strawberry half that's put on the top. It can be really pretty if you work on it. Hope you enjoy this. Happy New Year's. Now I know you want me to take a sip of it, so I'm going to do that. Actually, the rum doesn't show up all that much. We might add some more rum to this. But the strawberry flavor is there, really potent. And also I can taste the pineapple and I can taste the coconut. So it's a very good drink. I guess we can stop right here.